It's done, then the other preparatory works like, you know, preparing the blue bill and all that will have to be done over the next few days. So once that is done, then we can table it sometime next week.
So there will be no more mandatory death sentence?
That will involve about 11 offences.
So 11 offences doesn't include drugs, yeah?
Oh, drug will be separate. Drug at this moment, under 39B, the government had already given the discretionary power to the judge, provided that the conditions, the four conditions under 39B2S are met. Right? So that has already been given. But then I am in the process of re-looking at that particular provisions, 39B2A. Because the four conditions that gave the judge the discretionary powers are too limited, and that it's not freely given to the particular convicted person, right?
So they're currently in death row?
In death row, the last count was about 1,290.
So will the act after class be retrospective and applies to those?
Oh, that one we are still considering at this moment, because the process of having to look at the moratorium will involve a process to look at the Lembaga Pengampunan, the Pardon Board, right, and with all the relevant stakeholders as well, because the process where a condemned person had been sentenced to death is a legal process first, right, whereby it is from the High Court to the Court of Appeal and then to the Federal Court. That process, once that is completed, you still have to go to the Pardon Board. Right.
It involves 11 laws, so is it going to be like one law at a time? The amendments will be done?
Oh no, amendment will be done completely toward these 11 offences, whereby the law will be amended where the particular offence touches on death sentence, mandatory death sentence. We take away that word mandatory and replace it probably with life imprisonment or 30 years, right? So there will be three choices for the judge to make. First is, after convicting that person to death, before sentencing, the judge will have to consider the various mitigation circumstances before he can decide whether to pass a death penalty or 30 years of life imprisonment without parole. That will depend on the facts and the circumstances of the case. So the judge, being the trial of facts and also trials of law, will have known by then when the person is convicted, why he did what he did, right?
Does it mean zero will be coming back soon?
Oh, I cannot answer you that question.
Datuk.